because I was presenting them with a philosophy which is desperately needed today and which doesn't exist anywhere else, because it was an absolute desert in literature, both literarily, both in regard to romantic realism. There were no such novels. Practically everything that was serious was naturalism in those years, and more importantly, it's the philosophy of individualism.
Why do you object to, or why do you not like novels which are close to life as it really is, naturalism?
Because I don't think it's art.
It's not art.
It's partly art. In other words, a naturalistic novel is an incomplete work of art. It has certain elements of art, such as characterization, or some of them have a good style. All that is artistic. But art primarily, and that I can prove philosophically, is a recreation of reality, not a photograph. Art is not journalism. It is a recreation of reality according to an author's metaphysical value judgments. Metaphysical.
Does that mean that
meaning.
You write only about what ought to be, not what is?
Yes, but let me finish. Mm. I use the big words, so I want to be sure that the audience does understand me. By metaphysical, I mean the nature of reality as such, the nature of existence. It's his view of man and of the nature of existence that a writer or any artist really expresses in art. And romantic art presents to man what he might be and ought to be. That is, it presents an ideal and tells man this is the essential nature of man, and you as a human being can become that if you wish. So that art in that sense, romantic art, is model building. Not, however, and I emphasize that, not for the purpose of improving or teaching your something to your readers.
Not teaching.
Oh, not teaching. Art should never be didactic. That's a secondary issue. That's pure gravy. The primary purpose of art is contemplation for its own sake. So that the purpose here is for the reader to see what greatness man is capable of, and to be inspired by that.
So as I read Atlas Shrugged, then, and any one of the heroic characters, Hank Reardon, or John Galt, or Francisco, these give me a model of the kind of person I might be?
If you wish, but that isn't my purpose in writing.
I see.
My purpose is for you to look at those people, and to enjoy the spectacle. As a secondary consequence, you might find yourself inspired. Yes. That's fine. But I want to give you that experience. And that's what I want to give myself. I write for the purpose of creating an ideal man in actions which he can respect and admire.